People are now, people are heading, because this is less impressive than the first one, my friend.
The first one's closed?
Yeah, this is, yeah, less impressive, it's closed. This is open. Here on your left side, you see a big building. This is the Solar Boat Museum. That all those are the tombs of the relatives and the nobles and the high officials who wanted to be very close to the pyramids. And now we are heading to see the Sphinx. On the way, the Sphinx will be entering the temple for mummification, known as the Valley Temple, in which King Khufu has been mummified for 70 days. The core of the temple is built from limestone, covered with ashlars of granite. Limestone covered with ashes of granite, 640 miles south of Cairo. So at that time they would mummify the temple here, mummify the king here in that temple, take him and go his way to the other temple, pray for him, and then finally bury him inside his pyramid. Each pyramid had a complex like this, but luckily this is the only complex that has survived in a partially good condition compared to the first one and the third. This is after mummifying the king here, they would take him in a cold way here to the other temple to pray for him in a temple called the Mortuary Temple. Then finally he will be buried inside his tomb. I want you to come and show you something. See, this is one piece. Count with me how many curves in this piece. This is the first curve, second curve, third curve, fourth curve, fifth curve, six, seven, eight, one solid piece of granite. Look at up there, hinges, hinges, which means that they had a door, two leaves opening inside to open for the procession of the mummy to get to the other side, to get to the other temple. And here are two side chambers with a staircase. Each one had a staircase so that the priest would be able to watch the procession of the procession of after mummification of the mummy from here to the other temple. The Sphinx is the biggest carved limestone piece in the world. It was excavated in 1818 by an Italian man called the Captain Caviglia, and it's a body of a lion and a head of a human being, representing the strength of the king in the body of the lion and his mentality and his being smart as a human being in the head of the Sphinx. The Sphinx's main function was for guarding the three pyramids. Guarding the pyramid of Khufu, the middle one, guarding the one of his father Cheops, guarding the one of his son Nikrinus, in addition to the cemetery around for those followers and high priests and high officials who wanted to be very close to the pyramid. The Sphinx, as you can see, is a head of King Khufu, who had at that time a full spear. So there was a statue of a full spear. 13% of this full spear between London Museum and the Egyptian.
This is the Sphinx. And it's here to protect the pyramids.
It's a body of a lion and a head of a human being.
See that piece of granite that's square? It's a